My name is Rafael Rizzari, and I'm a professor in the Department of Biostatistics and Computational Biology in the Dana-Farber Cancer Institute. My academic appointment is in the Harvard School of Public Health in the Department of Biostatistics. Statistics as a discipline was born out of people analyzing data, trying to solve real problems. And the theory and the methodology that we're going to learn in this class, it all came after people were struggling with analyzing data. So in that sense, when you're teaching it, it's much more efficient to show data first and see what the challenges are so that we can then understand why we're learning the theory and actually put the whole thing in context. Towards the end of the class, we're going to try to show the entire pipeline for four very specific problems that people are challenged with day in and day out across the research world. We're gonna actually show you real data, not toy examples. We're going to solve those problems, show you the code, and then at the same time, you will have seen the explanations of the methodology that we're using, why it's appropriate, and why it has a whole background, a whole mathematical background that gives us a sense that it's the right thing to do. So there's two specific technologies that are widely used among the research community: next generation sequencing and microarrays. We are going to focus on those two technologies in this class, although the methods and statistical concepts that we're going to learn are broadly applicable. We're actually going to focus on those two platforms. The software that we use is all open as well, and it's freely available on the internet. We're going to be using R, which is a programming language or environment for data analysis, and with many statistical tools already written for it. And we're also going to be using Bioconductor, a software infrastructure for genomics specifically, built on top of R. Today, in the 21st century, the data analysis happens on computers. So the classroom, many times in the past, has turned into sessions where we're trying to fix the computer and install all the right softwares. In this new format, people can do that all in the privacy of their own homes, hit pause. Once they're ready, they can go and do the analysis. So that's why a class like this is particularly appropriate to do in this format.